Hi. In this tutorial, we will see how we can control the creation of some objects by pressing the control key while creating these objects. We have two categories of objects, those with length and width in their parameters, and the other category is the category of objects with radius. Now we will start with objects with length and width, like the box. When you click and drag, you are dragging from the corner. Now I can press control before start clicking and dragging, or while I'm dragging, I can press the control key, and as you can see, the creation happens from the center, plus the width and length are constrained together, are locked together, so we will have a square. Now I can release the mouse button. I can release also the control key now. Now one benefit from this, for example, if I want to have the box, I want to have the center of the box to be on this corner, I can activate the snap, vertex snap, and click here, then press control, release the mouse button. I will try a couple of objects. I'm not gonna try all objects with length and width. You can experiment with yourself. For example, pyramid by default is created from the center, but if I click control, it will have a square base. Also, extended primitives, for example, chamfer box. Press control. Release the mouse button. You can release the control key. Now, and the shapes, for example, ellipse, it has a length and width. So if I will click and drag, now I will press the control key, and length and width are locked, so you will have a circle-like shape. Now we will talk about the category of objects with radius, let's say sphere. If I click and drag, now if I press the control key, I can rotate the sphere before the creation ends. I can use snap to snap to some direction. You can see the quadrant of the sphere is now at this corner. For example, I can start the sphere here and decide to have the quadrant at this corner, so I will press control to rotate it, and then I will release the mouse button. So you can see here, same thing for tube, for example, click and drag, press control, and you can rotate it. I will release the mouse button, but I'm still pressing the control key. Now I'm deciding the width, the depth of the thickness, sorry, for the tube, but because I'm still holding the control key, I still can rotate it. Now I will click the control, click the mouse button. Now I can release the control key. And now you can go and experiment with other types of objects and see how you can use this technique in your workflow. So that's it for this video. If you like it, press the like button, and please subscribe to the channel, and see you next time. Thank you.